Now, in this lecture, I would like to stress the importance of classifying the income. Now, in the previous lecture, we classified the income taxpayer. And at this juncture, we're still discussing on the individual income taxpayers. We're not yet discussing the corporations and the estates and trusts. For the meantime, yung classification natin for the individual income taxpayers, as you know, and then as what you have read, we have the resident, citizen, the non-resident, citizen, the resident, alien, non-resident, alien engaged, and those who are not engaged in trade or business. The sources on whether it is tax on all sources or tax on one sources within, or yung kanilang tax base as well as the tax rates. At least now you are already apprised on that. But next is the income. Why do we need to classify the income? The income may be exempt. It is now by virtue of the law, by provision of law, we have section 32B, the exclusions from gross income, or it is by treaty, yung agreement between the state, the Philippines, and some others, and some other countries exempting that particular type of income, say that is a passive income, or by provision of the constitution, yung mga constitutional limitations. The income may be exempt. We will set aside yung mga exempt income muna. For purposes of computation, makikita mo sa problem that the income is taxable. But why do we need to classify it whether it is part of gross income by an ordinary income? Subject to the ordinary income tax rules for those taxpayers tax based on the taxable income? Or is it one of the CGT transactions? The capital gains tax transactions? Or is it a passive income subject to final withholding tax? Why do we need to classify pa nga? Pwede namang itotal na lang in aggregate kung yung given sa problem and subject it to a tax rate. And that will be the computed income tax. You know what, in the Philippines, we have a complicated system. Now, because we are adopting a combination of global and the scheduler system of taxation. When we say global system of taxation, yung different types of income may be treated alike, treat or tax it in the same way, the same manner, same treatment. That is global. When we say scheduler system of taxation, different types of income will be treated differently. Will have a different tax treatment, will be taxed differently. That is scheduler. Unfortunately, in the Philippines, we are adopting combination of the global and the scheduler system of taxation. We have a complicated tax system. But we are trying to simplify everything, di ba? Now, but what is the importance? Ito yan. Yung mga compliances natin, class. Say that the income forms part of the gross income. Ordinary. Di ba? Mayroon dyan sa problem, asking for compute for the taxable income. Pag yan ay question is taxable income, ang next na yan, maybe how much is the income tax due or the income tax payable if there are available tax credits. Diba? And if that is so, the taxpayer is taxed based on the taxable income, we will be using the tax table. Yung ating rates ranging from 20% to 35%, but if the taxable income does not exceed 250,000 pesos, exempt yun. Diba? And we will be using that if what is being asked is taxable income. And ayan na naman, taxable income, ordinary income yun, that will form part of the gross income under Section 32A. Doon sa Section 32A, yung ating code, we have compensation, out of employer relationship, yan, material yan, magpo-fall yan ang number one. Dyan, meron tayong substituted filing of the income tax return by the employer if the employee is a pure compensation income earner with no other sources of income. Number two, we have gross income from business, trade, or practice of profession. Gains derived from dealings in properties, interest, rents, royalties, dividends, annuities, pensions, prizes and winnings, and partners' distributive share in the net income of general professional partnership. Yan naman, as I told you, i-discuss pa natin in a separate lecture. But for the meantime, why do I need to classify? Bakit siya for gross income? Kasi iba ang tax treatment at iba yun rin yung ating compliance. Magbigay tayo ng example. Now, say that that Mr. A is engaged in business. Meron siyang gross income from business, trade, or practice of profession. Engaged in business. Yan. In the conduct of trade or business. Paparegister yung kanyang business sa BIR. Get the necessary permits and licenses. And then register it before the Bureau of Internal Revenue. Magko-comply. Ano ang compliance niya? Magpa-file siya ng kanyang income tax returns. Merong tatlo quarterly income tax returns, BIR Form 1701Q. Ang deadline niyan, for the three quarterly income tax returns, on or before MANA, tatandaan lang yung MANA, May 15, August 15, November 15. For the first quarter on or before May 15 of the current taxable year, the second quarter on or before August 15 of the current taxable year, third quarter on or before November 15 of the current taxable year, cumulative yung pag-compute ng income tax. But as the quarter goes on, yung mga previously in quarterly income tax payments, pwede naman yung maklaim as tax credit. Pwede yung maklaim as tax credit. I-deduct doon sa computed cumulative na income tax. And at the end of the year, for 1 year, yan na yung annual income tax return ni taxpayer, individual income taxpayer, engaged in trade or business, he will be filing BIR Form 1701. It's either 1701 if he is mixed income earner, meron siyang gross income from business, may rents pa siya, say, may royalties pa, may interest. That would form part of the gross income, hindi passive income, hindi CGT. Pag mixed income earner siya, BIR Form 1701. Pag purely from business, trade, or practice of profession, BIR Form 1701A. Now, ang deadline niyan, on or before April 15, following the end of the taxable year. And notably, for our individual income taxpayers, calendar year lang yan. Calendar year lang ang pwedeng i-adopt as a taxable year. Now, which means na beginning January 1, ending December 31. Ibig sabihin, if you are engaged in, say, yung ating ordinary income, engaged ka in business, trade, or practice of profession, yan ang compliance mo. Meron kang compliance. Diba? You need to file and pay your, file your return and pay your income tax. Tatandaan yan. Now, in relation thereto, yung computed for taxable income, yung computed for income tax due. Doon sa income tax due, there are some items that can reduce your income tax due kasi meron ka ng mga previous income tax payments. Now, and that is what we call as the tax credit. Titingnan ang problem, if what is being asked in the problem is the income tax due or income tax payable. If the requirement in the problem is income tax payable, titingnan mo yung mga sources of tax credits. As I told you a while ago, one source is what? Yung mga quarterly income tax payments mo, previous quarterly income tax payments mo. At the end, doon sa iyong annual income tax return, pwede mo yung i-claim as tax credit. Ano pa yung another source? In the previous lecture, sinabi natin, meron tayong mga foreign income tax paid. Diba? Pero dapat declared yan sa gross income mo, baka ma-assess ka ng BIR. Yung mga foreign income tax paid, you can claim that as tax credit subject to limitation. May choice ka naman doon if allowable deduction or tax credit, but subject to limitation if you will be claiming that as a tax credit. Now let me cite another example. Ito, compliance na naman. Ordinary income tayo, gross. income that would form part of the gross income necessary for the computation of your taxable income, necessary for the computation of the what we call the income tax due or income tax payable. Okay? Now, say that na DJ na is engaged in the practice of profession, exercise of profession. Now, in the course of na practicing the profession, syempre merong PF yan, professional fee. And the clients are giving what? Payments. Issue ng OR si DJ. Di ba? And the client na will withhold. Nagwi-withhold si client. Bibigyan si DJ ng ano? We have our BIR form 2307. Doon sa BIR form 2307, nag-withhold yung client, yung payer, payin natin si DJ, yung income tax payer or income earner. Di ba? Now, bibigyan siya ng BIR form 2307 for that na creditable or expanded na withholding tax. Now, yung gross income from practice of profession, ordinary income. Dapat naka-declare lahat ng na kanyang naresibuhan or kanyang na-record, naka-declare yan sa kanyang gross income. If it is subject to withholding, creditable withholding tax, creditable withholding tax na ayan for the professional service fees now bibigyan siya ng BIR form 2307 so that na he can na or si DJ can claim it as a source of tax credit kung ano man yung declared na income doon including the gross income whatever we build the withholding tax withheld by the withholding agent, yung payor, can be claimed as tax credit. Okay. And also kasi the payor, say the client, cannot claim that as allowable deduction in their own return or yes, income tax return unless nag-withhold. And that there must be proper withholding of the tax and the withholding agent is liable to the government for failure to withhold. Kaya mandatory. But as I told you, the withholding tax is only a system of collection. To facilitate or hasten the tax collection system. Yan, BIR Form 2307. Anong deadline yan? On or before 20th day of the month after the taxable quarter. And that BIR Form 2307, if a file ng ating non-taxpayer together with the BIR Form 1701Q. Kasi nga, i-claim niya yun as tax credit. Nag-withhold yung withholding agent. Unfair naman yun if he cannot claim that as tax credit para ma-reduce yung kanyang babayarang income tax. Kasi income tax due, less the tax credit, income tax payable. Okay. Now, another point. Say that na DJ is likewise employed. Employed si DJ. Meron siyang compensation arising from employer-employee relationship. You will notice that the employer is also withholding tax. Diba? Now, pero ang compensation income ba saan siya? Passive income ba yun? CGT? No. Part siya ng gross income. Now, whatever would be the compensation income, that will form part of the gross income together with the other income of our taxpayer, de-declare pa rin yan sa kanyang return, income tax return. Now, unless pure compensation income earner wherein the substituted filing of income tax return may apply or can apply. Now, say that the taxpayer is a combination mix, may compensation income and the employer is withholding the tax. Of course, our employee, the income earner with mixed income, is entitled to tax credit kasi nag-withhold. Claim ko siya as tax credit, na? And the employer will give or accomplish, na, what we call the BIR Form 2316. Now, BIR Form 2316. This will be given to the employee on or before January 31 after the year the payment was made. So that in the annual income tax return of the employee, si DJ, the annual income tax return of DJ, yung mga income tax withheld on compensation can be claimed as tax credit. O ibig sabihin, we have the compliances. Merong compliance report or BIR form to be filed. Si ating income taxpayer, pati rin yung ating withholding agent. Now, and if that income would form part of the gross income, it is an ordinary income, and na subject to withholding, yan ay creditable, expanded, creditable withholding tax. Kaya siya creditable withholding tax kasi pwede mo siyang i-claim as tax credit. Ano nga ulit yung concept of tax credit? This can reduce your computed income tax due for you to arrive at what we call income tax payable. Kaya payable, yan na lang yung babayaran mo kasi previously may mga nag-withhold na ng income tax mo or may mga previous tax payments ka. Of course, because equity requires that should be claimed as a form of credit to minimize or for now reduce your tax because you already paid previously your income tax. Yan, plus may compliance pala, tapos may mga periods to consider, may BIR form now required. And this is for ordinary income. Pag sinabi natin ordinary income, this would form part of the gross income. Necessary dun sa pag-compute natin ng taxable income. For those taxpayers tax based on the taxable income, kasi syempre ibayin muna natin yung sa non-resident area natin, which is trader business, kasi lagi naman yan naka-final withholding tax of 25% and based on the gross, walang allowable deduction. Now, for purposes of computing income tax due or income tax payable, meron tayong compliance, and that is subject to ordinary income tax rules. Now, next, how about passive income? Bakit kailangan pa natin na i-classify? I told you to memorize the different passive income subject to final withholding tax. I will make a separate lecture comparing yung may mga compositions kasi sa gross income na parang similar sa passive income subject to final withholding tax. Katulad ng interest. May interest sa gross income. May interest income din naman sa passive income. Interest income on bank deposit. Deposit substitute, trust fund, or similar arrangement. Ano bang difference nung sa gross income na ordinary income dito sa passive income subject to final withholding tax? Merong prices. Di ba? May prices and winnings doon sa gross income. Meron din namang prices dito. May prices and prices exceeding 10,000 pesos. And winnings. Meron doon sa passive income subject to final withholding. I will make a separate lecture for that. But for the meantime nga, what I would like to stress in this lecture, why do we need to classify the income? Kasi iba ang treatment, iba ang compliance niyan. Different types of the income. Pag passive income subject to final withholding, this is final withholding tax and not creditable. Pag final withholding tax, it is a final and full settlement of the tax liability and the income taxpayer need not declare. Hindi na niya kailangang ideklara sa kanyang income tax return, yung pinaprepare niya na quarterly or pag meron siyang negosyo or the annual income tax return. If the income is already a passive income subject to final withholding tax. Kasi final and full settlement of the tax liability and it will already be the obligation of our withholding agent. Jose, passive income subject to final withholding tax. Now we have the BIR Form 2306. And the deadline needs to be accomplished by the withholding agent on or before January 31 after the year the payment was made. This is accomplished by the withholding agent, yung ating BIR Form 2306, and this is for the annual. Diba? Meron tayong BIR Form 2307. Doon saan yan? Doon sa ating creditable, doon sa expanded withholding tax, 2306, in case of our final, passive income subject to final withholding tax. And we have the BIR Form 1601 FQ, filed not later than the last day of the month following the end of the taxable quarter during which the withholding was made. And these are what? These are to be accomplished by the withholding agent. The taxpayer need not worry. Kasi someone will withhold, ibabawas na, ikakaltas na. Someone will prepare and accomplish the BIR form and will pay to the BIR through the accredited agent bank. Diba? Bigay tayo ng example. Say, the interest income on bank deposit. Now, Mr. A has a savings account in BDO. Mr. A is a resident citizen. Makikita ni Mr. A in his passbook na doon yung kanyang balance. Tapos merong maliit na amount. Diba? Na interest income. But in that interest income na naa-add doon sa kanyang balance, diba? In that interest income, there is this deduction. And that is the final withholding tax. The final withholding tax rate, 20%. For our resident citizen in case of interest income on bank deposit. Diba? Now, merong 20% na nababawas doon sa kanyang interest income. Question, diba? Is Mr. A required to declare kung ano yung nandung interest income sa kanyang annual income tax return or kanyang income tax return to be accomplished and filed to the BIR? Hindi. Because it is a final and full settlement of the tax liability, it will already be the obligation of our withholding agent, yung banko. The bank will be the one to accomplish the form, dinededuct yung final withholding tax. Dinededuct yung tax, accomplish the form, and subsequently pay. File it and pay to the BIR. That is passive income subject to final withholding tax. Say that you won in a beauty contest, nanalo ka sa beauty contest, how much? 100,000 pesos. Diba? Yung sponsor mo, gave you 80,000 pesos. And then you are asking, bakit 80,000 pesos? Because you will still be paying the tax. Did you accomplish any form? Hindi. Hindi ka na nag-accomplish ng BIR form. Did you pay it personally? Hindi rin. Because someone will do that for you and that is the withholding agent. The withholding agent will withhold and pay it to the BIR and accomplish the BIR form. It's a final and full settlement of the tax liability. Unlike a creditable withholding tax. Ang creditable withholding tax, you need to get the copy of your 2307 so that you can claim it as tax credit. And whatever income subject to creditable withholding tax should form part and be included in your gross income. And you just claim whatever withholding tax withheld as tax credit. Partner-partner yung class. You need to declare up. You cannot claim tax credit kung hindi mo naman dineclare up and sa gross income mo yung source of that creditable withholding tax. Yan, creditable withholding tax to be distinguished from a final withholding tax. But in both cases, meron tayong withholding agent. It facilitates the administration of tax collection. Napapadali siya kasi may meron nang nangungulekta, parang on behalf of the BIR, on behalf of the taxpayer, someone will do to facilitate the tax collection. Now, in the capital gains tax transactions, we have two. And we will still discuss this in a separate lecture. The capital gains tax on sale of real property held as capital asset, and the capital gains tax on the sale of shares of stock held as capital asset not traded or listed through the local stock exchange. Not traded, direct sale to buyer yet. If it is traded or listed through the local stock exchange, not subject to income tax because it is subject to stock transaction tax. That is 6 over 10 of 1% based on the gross selling price. Not subject to income tax. Hindi siya CGT. Now, ma'am, why do we need to classify that? Kasi iba na naman ang compliance. Ibang compliance pala ng mga gross income. Iba rin ang compliance ng passive income kasi that will be the duty and obligation of the withholding agent. Iba rin ang compliance ng CGT. Ang BIR form natin, we have BIR form 1706 for sale of real property held as capital asset and BIR form 1707 for the sale of shares of stock not traded or listed through the local stock exchange. At deadline natin, 30 days dito. 30 days after each sale, barter, exchange, or other disposition of property, shares of stock, not traded or listed through the local stock exchange with authorized agent bank, under the jurisdiction of the RDO where the seller or transfer is required to register. Tingnan nyo, 30 days. Iba rin doon sa passive income subject to final withholding. Iba yung deadline ng ating withholding agent. Iba rin yung deadline natin for the gross income subject to ordinary income tax rules. And that is what I would like to emphasize. That you need to classify correctly the income kasi iba ang tax treatment, iba rin ang compliance. Okay. Now, say that we have DJ will register the business. Register mo yung business mo. Fill up ka dyan ng BIR Form 2303. Register natin yung ating business and then you will renew it, your registration every year. And once you register, ito yung ating offline BIR forms. Ano na siya? Perhaps because of the administrative feasibility to facilitate the collection of taxes, meron na rin tayong mga accredited agent bank, di ba? Na RDO or the taxpayer is registered, download ka na lang ng iyong EBIR forms. This is downloadable. Tapos once you download your system, the package, every time that you will enter, para nandiyan na rin yung inyong TIN, yung name ng ating taxpayer, nandiyan na la RDO, and every time that you will be paying your BIR taxes, ayan siya, okay, titingnan mo na lang, kung yan ba ay sa withholding tax, sa inyong income tax return, business tax, ayan, nakalist na yung BIR forms. Now, all you have to do is to enter and fill in the information in the BIR forms. Now, what I would like to stress at this point in time, bakit ba natin kailangan i-classify yung income? Kasi nga, iba yung tax treatment at iba rin yung compliance. And if you did not classify it properly, you might be assessed by the BIR. And that is the reason why, time and again, when we started discussing income tax, I told you to memorize the tables. Memorize it by heart, that table of the passive income, the rates applicable depending on the classification of the taxpayer and the CGT transactions. And later on, what you will memorize will be the exclusions or the exempt income, the exclusions from the gross income. I hope you were able to rationalize, class, the importance of classifying the income. Kasi iba-iba yung ating mga compliances, iba yung ating mga BIR forms, iba ang deadline, iba ang tax treatment. Okay.